I'm preaching a message for 20 minutes, and the title of the message is Only You. Tell somebody, only me. Only. Oh, come on. Tell somebody, only me. All right, Job chapter 1, verse 13. We read verse 13 and we read verse 16. Today, I want you to be so radical and crazy. You are going to receive something. When you feel like jumping, jump. When you feel like shouting, shout. When you feel like rolling, roll. When you feel like taking your wake, take your wake off. Shout, only me. All right. One day when Job's sons and daughters were feasting and drinking, someone shout feasting and drinking. Wine, they were feasting and drinking wine at the oldest brother's house. A messenger, someone shout a messenger. A messenger came to Job and said, the oxen were plowing and the donkeys were grazing nearby, and the Sabaeans attacked and carried them off. They put the servants to the sword, and I am the only one who has escaped to tell you. Someone said, hey. Oh, today I pray that you will be the only one to escape the trap of the enemy. 16, he said, while he was still speaking, another messenger came. Ladies and gentlemen, have you realized that it's so painful in life that while in your hardest time, while you are dealing with a problem, another one comes up. Whilst you are going through the divorce, there comes a police case from your son. In the name of Jesus, may God deliver you from every attack of the enemy. In the name of Jesus. Someone shout, only me. All right. While he was still speaking, another messenger came and said, the fire of God fell from the sky and burned up the sheep and the servants. And I am the only one. Someone shout, only one. Oh, who has escaped to tell you. Shout, I will escape. All right. Verse 17, while he was still speaking, another messenger came. Haven't you realized that it's so painful whilst you are still dealing with a problem at the office, at your workplace? They call you back home that something has happened to your mother, something has happened to your father. And imagine what Job was going through. Today, I was there today, and God was laying these things on my heart. And I was just imagining the whole scenario. The first one talks about oxen and donkeys. When you read the NLT, the Bible says that the oxen and the donkeys, they were stolen. One of the assignments of the enemy is to steal something from you. The enemy, he came to kill, to steal, and to destroy. In the name of Jesus, whatever thing that you have been struggling for, no enemy can steal it. Oh, come on, come on. I said, no enemy can steal it. And he said that the brothers and the Job's sons and daughters, they had all gathered, and all of a sudden there was an attack that came upon them. It came on a group number of people, but there was one person amongst them that the attack couldn't kill. Ladies and gentlemen, the devil should get ready, because if he can kill people in the family, not you, because an anointing is falling upon your life. Only you will escape the trap of the enemy. Only you cannot be rejected. Only you. Oh, someone shout, only me. Oh, come on, shout it, only me. Oh, come on, shout it, only me. Ladies and gentlemen, I came to announce to somebody that there are some people in life, you can't just kill them. There are some people in life, you can't just damage them. Some time ago, I used to hold all nights in Derby. I used to hold all nights, large crowds, over 700 people. I used to hold all nights in Derby when I was doing my master's. crowds of people, I called the lady out. I said, may God mark you. May something happen to your house. Or what the lady shouted was, amen. Ladies and gentlemen, just after the all night, there was a fire outbreak in the lady's area. All the houses got burnt from number 17, from number 17 to 18. If the lady was in number 19, the fire jumped from number 19 and went to number 20. That day, I realized that the devil can attack people, but there are some people, oh, come on. There are some people that you cannot attack them. The Bible said a messenger came out and told Job that the enemy came. He killed all the servants, but only me and my family. Can I prophesy? Only you and your children. You cannot, oh, come on. I said, only you. Who said, I receive it. Said, I receive it. Sit down for 1 minute. Am I preaching somebody at all? And this was what I saw. Listen, it's a word from God. When I saw this thing, something came into me. The verse 18, he said, while he was still speaking, 18, give it to me on the screen. He said, yet another messenger came and said, your sons and daughters were feasting and drinking wine at their oldest brother's house. When suddenly, the NLT says, when suddenly a powerful wind swept in from the desert and struck the four corners of the house. Listen to me. It collapsed on them. The servant was in the house. The wind collapsed on them. But only the servant. You know something? People will be complaining in London, England. But only you. Oh. Do you believe in this prophetic word at all? People will be complaining, but only you. The devil cannot attack you. The Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom shall I fear? The Lord is the stronghold of my life. For whom shall I be afraid? I declare over your life, only you and your family. When people are dying, you cannot die. When people are falling, you cannot fall. Shout yes! Oh, come on. Shout yes! Someone shout, only me. Come on, 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 shout, only me. If I were you, after the service tomorrow, you'll be walking on the streets of Peckham and you'll be telling people, when they greet you good morning, you respond, only me. When they say, how are you? You tell them, only me. There are some people you cannot just kill. There are some people you cannot just kill. You heard recently of the plane crash that happened with the footballers. Some people died, but one person, some people got out. They can put you into the pit. I am preaching to somebody. You can attack a lot of people, but I am a child of God. I am a covenant child of God. You cannot kill me. Yet though I walk through the valleys of the shadows of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy strength and thy shaft, they comfort me. Thou anointed my head with oil. Thou prepared a table before me in the presence of my enemies. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow my life all the days of my life, and I will dwell in London Prayer Center, the house of testimonies. I cannot die. I am untouchable. I am undiable. Only me and my family. Am I preaching to somebody at all? There are some people you will sit down and just act like spectators, but I'm telling you, there's an anointing that is coming on somebody. There is some power that is coming on somebody. Oh, somebody said, only me who are feeling. Sit down for 1 minute. Am I preaching somebody at all? Who am I preaching somebody at all? 1 Samuel chapter 22. Oh, I feel like preaching. The devil is in trouble. I said the devil is in trouble. This year you can attack my family, but not me. Oh, I feel it. 1 Samuel chapter 22. This was when Saul ordered the servants to kill some priest. 1 Samuel chapter 22. When I saw it, he said, the king then ordered, give me the verse 18. You turn, verse 18, 22, verse 18. The king then ordered, as for this name, I don't know how to mention it. It's D-O-E-J. Whether it's dog or doig or, I cannot mention it. I did my master's in Brunel, but they didn't teach me this pronunciation. Let me continue. You turn and strike down the priest. So the name, the Edomite, turned. Wait. He turned and struck them down. That day, he killed Jesus Christ. He killed 85 men. Someone said 85. Okay. Push somebody to the person, 85. That day, he killed 85 men who wore the linen ephod. Give me the 19. He also put to the sword. Oh, I feel it coming here. He also put to the sword Nob, the town of the priest, with its men. Oh, these people were wicked. With its men and children, women, infants, and its cattle, donkeys, and sheep. Give me the 20. This is what I like. But, oh, someone shout, but. Oh, come on, shout, but. But Abiathar, a son of Ahimelech, son of Ahitom, escaped and fled to join David. Meaning that he killed only 85 men, but there was one other man. Oh, come on, I'm not talking to somebody at all. Continue with me. But Abiathar, son of Ahimelech, escaped and fled to join David. Give me the next verse. Oh, quickly, he told David that Saul had killed the priest of the Lord. Give it to me. Then David said to Abiathar, that day when the Edomite was there, I knew he would be sure to kill Saul. I am responsible for the death of your father's whole family. Can I talk to somebody? May the anointing of Abiathar. People have taken knife. They are killing 85 people, but only you. Oh, I said only you. You will escape. Shout, I will escape. Shout, I will escape. Shout, I will escape. Shout, I will escape. Psalm 124, verse 7. 124, verse 7. I'm going to declare this over our lives. I feel an anointing that is coming upon somebody that only you and your family. We have escaped like a bird out of the foulest snare. The snare has been broken. Am I prophesying to somebody? I prophesy over your life. You will escape like a bird out of the foulest snare. You cannot die before your time. I declare as a prophet, as Abiathar escaped, you will escape that trap. Only you and your family, you will escape. Son, I will escape. You have been going through a whole lot, but I get a word from the Lord for you. Weeping may endure for a night, but joy comes. Woman, may God deliver you. May God set you free. Whatever pain you have been going through, only you. I said only you. Shout, only me. Am I preaching? Sit down for a minute. Am I preaching? Shout, only me. I'm closing. Then we are going to release the only me anointing. Only me anointing. I wrote something here in my notes. He said, go and tell my people that if nobody has built a house, only you, you build a house. The one that shouted the loudest amen, receive that power. The one that stood up and shouted amen, receive that anointing. Hey! Hey! Receive it now! Receive it now! Shout yes! Shout yes! You know what? You got to go to six people and tell them that only me, I will prosper. Only me in my family. Go to six people. Go to six people. Tell them only me. Only me. Get up. Get up. Go to six people. Tell them you will. Oh, I feel it. I feel it. I feel an anointing. I feel some power. Hey! Only me. My God, my God. Only you. Only you, 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 shout only me, shout only me, shout only me, shout only me. Shout only me. Shout only me. Let me give you the one last one. Let me give you one last. Sit down, sit down. Am I preaching to somebody? Come on, am I preaching? Am I preaching to somebody? Joshua chapter 6 verse 17. Oh, I feel it. The devil, you will try your best. You can go every mile. You can take me to a babalawo, to a necromancer, to a juju man. Woo. He said the city and all that is in it are to be devoted for the Lord. Only Rahab, the prostitute, and all who are with her in her house shall be spared. Can I talk to somebody? Not only you will be spared, by your children, by your brothers, by your sisters, by your family, by your loved ones. May God preserve your family. Shout yes. I was watching some testimony on Facebook. I don't know if some people watched it. There was a man that went to Bishop Oyedepo's church, I think after Shiloh convention. And the man said he had parked his car by a gas station. And I think he just got out from the car to do something. So when he came back, there was a fire outbreak. You saw it. There was a fire outbreak in the gas station. And everybody's car was burnt. Everybody's car, if there were 8 cars, they were all burnt. His car was the one in the middle. This car never scratched up. There I understood that the devil can burn people, but there are some people you can't touch their property. No devil can touch your business. Oh, am I in London Prayer Center? No devil can touch your children. No devil can touch a cadaver. You are the son of God. Oh my God. No devil can touch your children. I remember when am I preaching at all? Am I preaching? I remember when I was in class 2 or class 4. In Ghana, I just remember that sometimes our class teacher will come to class and will be beating us. But sometimes it gets to some children. The class teacher will just beat them small because of their father. Hey, because when you hit them and there is a mark, they will tell their father, I got news for the devil. You can be hitting everybody, but my father is the King of Kings. He's the Lord of Lords. You cannot touch me. Don't touch me, devil. Don't touch me. I am a child of God. You cannot touch me. Am I preaching to somebody? You cannot touch me. I prophesy this midweek service. No devil can touch you. No power can touch you. When they carry your name to a fetish priest, may tender appear, may the blood appear. You will escape that trap like the bird of the foulest snare. Let God arise, let every enemy scatter. I feel an anointing, my eyes have been opened. I see the hand of God lifting people from pit. It's your time for favor. It's your time to shine. In a closed door, I prophesy, let that door be opened in the name of Jesus. Behold, I give you an open door, open business. Any spirit, any principality, any demon from your father's house, any demon from your mother's house that is fighting your life, I stand as a prophet and I crush that demon. I stop them in the name of Jesus. If I were you, I would get up, I will walk through the building and I'll prophesy that my children are blessed, my family are blessed. I'm coming out from that house. I'm coming out from that pit. It's our time to shine. You cannot attack me. The messenger that came out of Job's children, you will be that messenger. You cannot die before your time. Receive that power. This is my message. God says, I should give you. It's your time for that miracle. Receive it now. Say it. Say it. Say it.
Last one. Sit down. Am I preaching? Last one. Let me cut it. Let me pray. Today we're going to close early. Tomorrow is all night. Please, tomorrow, don't miss the all night for anything. Don't say there's traffic. Tomorrow, start at 10. Come on time. Tomorrow, I might get a microphone at 10, and I'll continue until 4. I'm telling you. Don't joke. Listen. We are not joking here. We want to see people blessed. Testimony are coming. The lady is here, but I can't mention. She was there. I went to her. I said, I see them cutting your breast. She said, I see them cutting your breast. 2 days later, she got a letter from the hospital that, come, we have found something in your breast. So she came back. I said, do this direction. I gave her the direction. She's in the church, but you know, as for breast issues, you can't. So I can't mention, I can't call her. So she just came to the office. And she, when he came, she said, Man of God. I said, hey. I said, what is it? She said, Man of God, there is nothing in the breast. Hey. I declare testimonies over your life. Shout hallelujah. Luke chapter 5 verse 1. I'm closing on this. Luke chapter 5 verse 1. This is the prophecy I'm going to release over somebody who have filled the anointing. Luke chapter 5 verse 1. He said, one day as Jesus was standing by the lake of Gennesaret with the people crowding over him and listening to the word of God. Next verse quickly. He saw at the water's edge two boats. Hey, someone saw two boats. Hey, left there by the fishermen who were washing their net. I decided to study this scripture well. Please, there is no way you can go by a sea and you will see only two boats. There were lots of boats. But because Jesus wanted to go to this family, that is why they said two boats. He got into one of the boats, the one belonging to Simon. I said, God, are you a partial God? He said, no. I bless whom I want to bless, and I curse whom I want to curse. Because I was thinking that if the boats were two, you would either use one for some time and use the other. But the Bible said, when favor locates you, only you, your boat, God. And can I say something? I see Jesus coming by your house lane. You pass by number 5, number 6, and will enter into your house. May God enter your boat. Someone said, only my boat. Shut it, only my boat. Shut it, only my boat. Am I preaching? Two boats. Sometimes when, listen, when you're walking here, raise your shoulder. And when they ask you why, you tell them that Jesus is in my boat. Am I talking to somebody at all? Listen, may Jesus, two boats. He said he entered into the one belonging to, and he wrote the name. Put your name there. Belonging to Louisa. Belonging to Esther. Belonging to. May God visit your house. Oh, may God visit your house. May God, listen, I just heard something. There'll be lots of documents on the table, but the immigration officer will pick only your documents. Oh, there'll be a lot of children, but your child will be selected to walk on the red carpet. Am I talking to somebody? Receive it now. Receive favor. Receive joy. Receive long life. Shout yes. Shout yes. Shout yes.
Rise onto your feet. Get up. I'm done. Get up. Rise onto your feet. Lift your two hands up. Lift your hands up. Lift your hands. Lift your hands. Lift your hands. So we lift up holy hands in one accord. I want every hand to be lifted. Come on. Singing blessed be the name. Come on, London Prayer Center, only you. I'm talking about only you. Blessed be the name. Blessed be the name. Lift your hands up. Of the Lord. So we lift up holy hands with one accord. I want you to lift your hands up. I'm closing. Singing blessed be the name. Hallelujah. Blessed. Only